morning, Council. My name is Janise Afolo. I live at Pavilion Apartments. I stand before you, and I want to thank all the council members who have been more than willing to meet with the tenant advocates on the rent control ordinance. I am just concerned about the particular part of the substantial rehabilitation. Councilman James was so graciously explained to us that we would not be affected, the tenants who are already living in our apartment complex. But that's not the case. It is happening, whether we want to accept it or not. How it's going about, you know, that's the landlords. But we do have good landlords, we have bad landlords. And unfortunately, the good landlords are getting mixed up with the apples and oranges of the bad landlords. How do we fix it? I don't know. How do we make those bad landlords realize that they need to bring our buildings up to code? The problem is, at the Pavilion, we are in desperate need of renovations. We started the renovations, and for some of you who have been at the Pavilion, you saw the renovated floors. Well, they're still looking. The same renovated floors are still there, and the ones that have not been renovated. Now, my president and I, we have met with our manager last year. We were very much involved with the new renovations that they were bringing forth. So we were told that in November that those renovations will be happening about 30 days later. Well, we're now in March, and those renovations have not happened. I believe I did send Councilman James some pictures of what our hallways look like. The carpet on the particular third floor. If you walk too fast, you will trip over the garbage rooms, and these things are a concern. While we have also put the small landlords into this whole mix, how do we fix that? Because the small landlords are getting involved with the bigger complex. So we need to look at a bigger picture rather than looking at a smaller picture. And we need to also, as the tenant advocate said, we need to sit down with some of these landlords. We need to tell them that they need to come and from their Alpine, New Jersey homes, from their Franklin Township homes, or Los Angeles, California, they need to actually come and see what it is like for us to fight for the littlest things to be put into our apartments. Is the 20% doable? I think that if we can come up with something that we all can live with, yes. But I keep going back to the same thing. When the landlords were getting our 4% and 5%, they were not doing anything for us. It still was a battle. Now they're not getting their 4% or 5% because of the CPI, and then $500 was nothing. So I'm asking the council to please, please bring the landlords to the table and let them hear what we are saying. Thank you.
Some of the people who were in those rooms when we tried to arrange a meeting. for the tenants and the landlords to come together. That didn't happen.
Okay.
That did not happen, and that's unfortunate because it should happen. Because at the end of the day, you know, I hear a lot of buzzwords being thrown around, gentrification. I hear words being thrown around that, you know, brown versus whites and all this stuff. Or that the council is not hearing your cry. The only reason why Gail Cheney put it, I can't speak with nobody else. The council president said yesterday was a meeting in which there was a discussion regarding this particular ordinance. I wasn't at that meeting yesterday. But I can tell you one thing, that one of the things that I've always said, and I originally was co-sponsoring some legislation with Councilman Ramos, and I took my name off that legislation because the legislation that appeared was not the legislation that I had worked on and put forward. The legislation that came from the administration, I was not in agreement with, okay? The legislation that is up here now, I think that there is not a problem with this council looking and taking some of the things that you said into consideration in doing this ordinance. And I will tell you one of the things that I go for. When you talk about the arbitration outside the court system, yes, the council has no business hearing rent control issues. We should not be hearing that. But then again, there are people who are not going to be able to afford an attorney. And I know that they will, there will be people who will not be able to afford an attorney. So somebody mentioned the fact that there should be a mediator process that is implemented. That's something that should be taken into consideration. The fact that the rents are going to increase, I still cannot for the life of me understand. If you were satisfied with Matt Shapiro's statement of 12 months, and you just shave off 4 months of that, then what is that 8 month, what is that 4 month difference going to quantify into 20 months? And I'm going to, but excuse me, Eric. All right, let me just finish what I have to say. I don't see where that 4 months is going to make a difference and automatically jump up to 20% the rent. And I still have not gotten my hands wrapped around this whole deconstruction or de-evaluation. Deregulation. So I don't see why we have to change it. It was the legislation, I'm going to tell you what I said before and I stand on it. The legislation that it appeared to be too pro-tenant and not enough to give the landlords an incentivization to do the substantial rehabilitation that needed to be done. But the tenants are raising issues that I think should be included in the legislation. So this today is not the reason why we have to hurry and vote on it, because there have been points that have not been brought before that will allow us to work with the tenants, work with the landlords, increase this, and then make it better legislation for everyone else. And I'm just saying that because, yes, I said in the beginning that this legislation to me was not the Obamacare. It wasn't going to be the end all be all. It wasn't going to be the panacea to save everything. But if you think for 1 minute that there's not legislation, I mean, there's legislation that's going to be put up that's going to keep your rent from rising, that is not true. So stop making people think that this is automatically going to shoot their rent up, because it's not. And stop making people think that they're being gentrified out of this city based on this resolution, because they're not. This resolution does not have anything to do with gentrification, because let me tell you something, darling. I lived in the city of Newark for over 50 some odd years, okay? And I remember when it was 500,000 people that lived in the city of Newark. We have enough room. This is not what's going to gentrify people. What's going to gentrify people if we turn around and allow people not to understand that they have a choice to stay here, and we create affordable housing. See, my family created affordable housing when you all weren't here. Okay? So that's my passion. And that's what Gail Cheney was about. So what I'm saying is, I see that there is still room to negotiate and look at this particular ordinance and have things put in that will strengthen the tenant side as well. So I always said that I thought it was too one-sided. And I think now it's going back to the other side. person and say, you know what, I don't like what you said, and this doesn't make sense. It was rushed through, and we still got a chance to fix it. Put your big girl panties on, your big boy panties on, and say, I can sit across the table from somebody who I have an opposite opinion. And let's meet midway, because I said, as far as the legislation I was concerned, everybody wasn't going to be happy. Some people are going to be mad, but as long as everybody walks from the table mad, then it's a compromise. This is not a compromise. Thank you.
All right.
It appears that many of you in this room, in fact, members of the council, live in luxury, that we live in gracious homes. I bought my house almost 60 years ago, but I was a tenant, as I said in that meeting yesterday. I was a tenant before I was a homeowner. I know what it's like, and so do all of us, every single one of us, we've been tenants as well. So don't think that your presentation, your anxiety over this issue goes right over our head.